This is Florina Kita Satchma, and today I am going to be bringing you part 10 of Let's Play Little Buster Q. The reason it's louder than normal is because I'm home alone. I can record this freely. No fucks given. Okay, well, now we're at people again. Okay, she looks like she's going to cry. Somebody else. Okay, it looks like they have a new playmate. I have to admit, he is fucking cute. Who can say no to that face? Something's going over. He knows you. Yeah, the thing is about this particular next area is that Rekka is staying put. You cannot coax him otherwise. There are no ifs, ands, or buts. Oh great, those kids want me to solve everything. So, yeah. Let's explore this place first. Kinda do a good layout. These guys in particular are going to be douchebags. With that attack they did, and they're doing like 35 damage to Yuki, yeah, they are going to be a problem. People aren't going to be as much of an issue. Their special attack only targets one person. And it inflicts a status shenanigan. The person who gets attacked by it lives, that is. Teddy girl has a special attack. I've never seen her use it at all. That will always cause an enemy to descend onto you. Before you ask, that enemy happens to be an airplane based. This is actually the part I was stuck at in my very first playthrough. After derping around heavily at the escalator. Yuki will rape you. What did I get? Okay, Okay, I got Mr. I think he's a curry dish. Dead end. Leave her alone. That's seriously the only explanation as to why the enemies have yet to touch Koto. Okay, now I just made that statement invalid. But that's the fun part of derping around. Abusing save states because I happen to be a fuzzy. Yeah. I happen to have tea in my bottle. Well, only one of two areas that will directly give you their names. This area is Bareta Airport. Look at this, she's just tanking this. She don't fuck around. Everything, absolutely everything, has been overtaken. Thank you. Now, I should bring up that a glitch that I brought up way back when. Okay. Well, if you use this ball in a specific spot, then you can go through the wall. Like, literally, into the black boundary of nothingness. And if you do it just right, then the game will crash. So, yeah. That's a very bad juju. Flavored Pringles are the shit. might as well take this off screen just to do this. Alright, I'm back. I cleared this entire area. Then I go over here. It's optional to beat these things, but... You don't have to flee from them either. I mean, it's up to you how you do it. Now you have a cutscene. Why not? Disappears. I do not know what they'll tell me. Looking on that machine. Ooh, it's a jam. And a soccer ball with a chance. Or whatever the hell that is. Bullshit today. That's fucking the horses you rode in. Something? Well, wow. I am a cookie. that thing. The thing in front of the statue was a monster, but you have to cut the whole thing down. Sorry I cut off the video. The thunderstorm hit me. I couldn't record that and mom was raging. So yeah. And like I said, be wary of the special attack. For your great train, if they can't, it will kill you in this part if you're not careful. Thank you. after you defeat the ear shield, yeah. And holy fucking shit. Yeah, just rinse and repeat, do the same here. Clear everything. I'm going to do that off screen. Alright, it turns out he died, playing at the end of our episodes for your fans. And then you see this thing. Kinda looks like the sun. Are you supposed to do? Throw the ball into it. Facing the runway. Which kinda looks like for some reason it's been molded after the leader of the Frontier Quartet. But boom! Yeah, this thing is not going down. And it also hurls flames. Flame bombs! Yeah. Seconds. think she has something to report. I'm not sure what. Cutting off the episode here. This is Florian and Kita Satana signing out.